Hello there, everyone, and welcome to, Pokémon 3, the movie. Hey, there's the title screen. Honestly, I don't know how well this is going to sync up with any of you, because it's very, very, very difficult to find this movie now, 22 years after the fact. Plus, it didn't seem like a lot of people cared for this movie all that much. I freaking loved it, though, but at the same time, I'd only seen, like, this one. I saw Pokémon the movie 2000... Pikachu the movie. Hang on a second. That's not even what this is called. So yeah, good luck. You can go on Amazon Video and you can find Pokemon 3 the movie, but it doesn't have this introductory short with Pikachu and Pichu. So I don't know. Good luck trying to sync this up with anything. I mean, you can find it out there because I found this cut somewhere, so... It's Togepi. I just hatched a Togepi on Pokemon Go. How dare you, Pipsqueak? Oh my god, that building is like weird. It's like in two dimensions. Or two different dimensions. So yeah, this is Pokemon 3 the movie. It's Pokemon. Bet you weren't expecting that. Well, you probably could have inferred that. What all have we watched on here? We've watched anime films, but like, well, I guess this is like a childish anime film, and I'm busy watching like Wolf Children that makes everyone cry with existential dread. Don't you just love Ash Ketchum's original voice? I remember I was watching one of the newer series with the new voice actor, and it's just not the same. Oh, the 3D animation! They balled out for the movie. Oh my god! It's weird 3D animation on top of 2D animation. So yeah, I don't know what Pikachu the movie 2001 was about, because that's not even the name of the short, so... It was just there. Yeah, good luck not destroying the whole skyscraper with that Onyx roaming around. I also like... They always do that stretchy face thing in Japan. I wonder where that like has its origins, like why that's a thing in Japanese media. The stupid Pichu. I remember back when I was growing up, we couldn't watch Pokemon. Because my parents were very pious at the time, and like, I don't know if they explicitly thought that Pikachu was, or Pokemon was like devil satanic stuff, but we couldn't watch Pokemon. But we managed to get into it like right before Johto stuff, so like we were like into the whole, those Murkrow are very evil. So, like, we knew Pokemon, like, the original 151, counting Mew. So we were like, in the know before Johto happened. And Johto was a big deal, because that was the first time they, like, expanded upon the number of Pokemon. So, this was all, like, a whole new exciting world. LOL. But this pneumonia in my eyes. What? Dude, who knew Murkrow were so evil? Pop-hip, pop-hip. I suck on that. Meanie. But yeah, as far as my investment in Pokemon goes, it kind of ended... When was Ruby and Sapphire was Hoenn? That was after this, right? Gen 3 was about as far as I got into Pokemon. See, and now it's super weird because I play Pokemon Go off, on and off. And, like, I don't know half of the well, I guess literally it's more than half. But I don't know. There's so many Pokemon in that, I've got no idea, like, who they are. It's only very rarely do I find a new Pokemon that I'm like, oh wow, like that one, the pink and brown teddy bear panda Pokemon, I'm all about whatever Pokemon that is. But it's like very few and far between that I find a new Pokemon that I'm like, ah, sweet, baller. Otherwise, I'm a purist. I like the original 150 and then up to Hoenn. Maybe I'm just too old, I guess. I did go through because I was curious because it's taken like Ash Ketchum like 20, 30 years to win the championship. And I went because I thought Pokemon was like Inuyasha. I thought it was like endless episodes. But like for each season slash region, the episode count's actually very tame. It's actually very manageable. Like there's like 40 episodes per region or something like that. I hope you can't hear my congestion like popping up. Oh, there's the Flatiron building. Whatever you do, don't use your electricity. I like how this short is basically just an excuse to put them in different environments where they see different. It's like a showcase of different Pokemon from Johto. By the way, Lapras, really, I love Lapras. That's very dangerous. He was in a canal, like in a major city. Why is there a Gyarados swimming through there? Is that a Houndour or a Houndoom? I can't recall the difference. You can tell this is the big bad city, the concrete jungle, because all the Pokemon here are mean. I did like Pokemon growing up, but we were very much into Digimon as well. The animated Pokemon? The animated Pokemon was always so weird growing up, because like half of the stuff that they do in these, you can't do in the games. And like, it was like Yu-Gi-Oh! I always thought it was like such a ripoff that like you couldn't do these things in the game. Like Pichu sucks in the video games, but like at the same time, oh, I wonder if I could like combine the two of them. Nope. Yikes. Oh no. Watch out. Oh Lord, he coming. Oh, he did. And then you had like Pokemon Coliseum on the N64, man. Mega, mega. Oh, it gets the playground. Come on! Smeargle. Oh, he's tagging the walls. Just some more of that weird 3D animation with 2D stuff on top of it. I love Furret. I love Wooper, too. Ah, that reminds me of the Tem Village from Undertale. That last one was Bob. Hit him on top! That was a lot of trust Pikachu had in a Hitmontop he had never met before. Whee! Pidgey! Just they just put a Pidgey there for no reason. Woohoo! Whee! I saw something on, one of my groups on Facebook, they were talking about how children in England, like, they could only name, like, 50% of common species, but, like, 80% of Pokemon. And somebody replied, they were all, yeah, but most of the natural wildlife in England doesn't yell their names at you. It's a good point. I love Oddish. I used to not care about Oddish, but in my advancing age, Oddish is pretty Balder. This is a lot of Pokemon, like, as a kid, I would not have given a second thought to, but now I'm like, oh yeah, they're actually pretty, like, Venonat. Venonat is straight up amazing. And, like, nobody gives a crap about Venonat, sadly. Communicating in Pikachu speak, or is it Pichu speak? Because they all start out as Pikachu. Here we go again. Dude, chill. Like, it's not worth it. You've exerted more energy than you would have gotten eating all of those mice. Gonna be a lousy return on your investment. They stole a lot of tires. Not them explicitly, but whomever put this thing over here. Like the Springfield tire fire over here. Now that's precarious. Oh no! I mean, if you do that, it's just gonna snap somewhere else on the rope. Their voice carries, that's for certain. What's Oddish doing? Oddish has no hands.
Chuckle.
Oddish, what are you doing? Dude, they've just got tires, like, crawling out of their ears. They're really trying to pad out the runtime of this short. They're trying to ascend from being a short to a full-on animation. Okay, surely you recruit more tires than that. Okay, Hitmontop's got impeccable aim. Not usually known for their engineering skills, Pokemon. Maybe this is all like in a dream. Like Pikachu just fell asleep on the skyscraper and he's imagining all this. It's almost 6 o'clock. I don't know if you guys realized it, but Ash gave them like 6 hours or like 7 hours to just hang out outside of their Pokeballs. Who knows how much havoc they could have wreaked upon the city. This seems dangerous. They can't even see where they're going. There you go. Team Rocket's blasting off again. Back to work, slave. No walls can contain these Pichus. Why isn't everyone else like, where the hell were you? And this all could have been avoided had those little Pichus not been little brats. Did none of the other Pokemon give a crap? Vulpix, best Pokemon ever. That day when Pikachu tried to kill him. That was like episode one. One of the most unreal, I was talking about like the dissonance between, oh, there's Bulbasaur. The dissonance between what you can do in the games versus the show. Yeah, one of the most unbelievable things in the animated media for Pokemon is that Pikachu was like, God tier. And he could like beat anybody in the show. But like in the game, Pikachu's like not even that good. Sadly, most in Pokemon now, sadly, most of the Kanto Johto Pokemon are pretty worthless because they're all one type. And all of the Pokemon now are like multiple types. Pikachu Project presents. Ooh, sunflowers. Sunflower fields forever. All right, so we're getting into the movie proper now. 18 minutes in. I kind of have to pay attention because I don't have subtitles. Yeah, this is the movie where Entei kidnaps Ash's mom. Entei's not even the best legendary dog. Come on now. Where's the Suicune movie? That's what we need. We also need to watch Pokemon the Movie 2000 because Lugia is a baller. Whoa! I hope they've got medical coverage. Yo, Dad, it's bedtime. Oh, Rapidash. Another good Pokemon. Look at Skype. She almost said Skype. Oh, you know what? I just noticed on the computer thing on the top left, it shows all of her Pokemon that she uses later. Was that subtle foreshadowing in a Pokemon kids movie? Oh my god. Don't worry, my child. I won't neglect you. Only in your dreams. Molly was not her name. in the original Japanese, I'm assuming. No, it was not. They're the Snowdens. Oh, you know what? They do have somewhat like westernized names, so I guess it's not completely out of left field. Her dad is Sully, and then her name is May. May Snowden. May is not all that westernized, but still. May is an M-E, not M-A-Y. There's already a May in Pokemon. Oh, Dan Green voices Entei in this movie, and the dad. Interesting. All the 3D animation. I know for a fact this didn't bother me when I was a kid. Now that I'm an adult, the animated dissonance like bothers me. Oh my god! It's unknown. Well, yeah, you've never been there. Of course it's unknown. Professor! Daddy! G chord. That's a big house for 1 8-year-old girl. Literally, look at that room. Do archaeologists in the Pokemon universe really make that much money? Damn, girl. Papa, that's not his name. I'm getting some like very strong Enya type 5 energy right now. Oh my god! We're being invaded by three-dimensional space! Oh my god! Yeah, that's not at all Johto. That is not at all the place in Johto where you find unknown. Oh my god! It's the Prince of Egypt! They're coming to kill the firstborn! Run! Run, Molly! Yeah, that'd be terrifying. Molly, you've got a bunch of floating eyeballs. Run. This also, Pokemon the movie 2000 also has like a much more of a massive scope to it. This movie is a lot more like self-contained as far as like how epic the storytelling is. Oh, that makes sense why he has the same voice then. There's a lot of things I did not pick up on when I was a kid. I just wanted Pokemon! Okay, so this isn't even really an Entei, or the real Entei. It's a fictionalized Entei. That Yugi Moto? Well, now you know why this film in Japan is called Emperor of the Crystal Tower. Why wouldn't you have imagined your dad to be Suicune? That would have been much better. Especially since Suicune is coded female. As far as I understand, anyway. I don't know. Do legendary Pokemon have gender types? I don't know. I'm assuming not, because they're like immortal deities. Well, they're not all immortal deities. Now they are. It's the Matrix! Which makes sense. Spell of the Unknown, Entei. That actually makes sense because the Matrix came out 2 years before this did. Even Pokemon wanted to be like the Matrix. It explicitly says on the Wikipedia page that this has an intro song, and that was not an intro song. Oh wait, no, that's not the intro song. We're about to get a banger intro song in a second. No shit, they've got a Pikachu and a Togepi. What do you think? Okay, your Pokemon are doing all the work, you know. That's not even a Great Ball. What Pokeball is that? Nothing makes sense if you compare this to the games. Watch how they fight. Oh, there's a Grabble. Like, this is how Pokemon battles go in the animated series. It's like in Yu-Gi-Oh, where they like actually use the environment to their advantage. That doesn't work in the card game. It's a whole new world we live in. It's a giraffe ring. One of the weirdest Pokemon. It looks so normal and yet so not. But you still gotta catch them all and be the best that you can be. Chikorita is also a favorite Pokemon of mine, and we're about to see them get absolutely destroyed right now. It hurt itself in its confusion. I also like the idea in this fight. I'm sure it happens in other places, but they're not fighting to the death, or I guess to the fainting. They're just like, oh yeah, I have the upper hand. Okay, let's switch Pokemon. That doesn't happen in the games. In the games, you're just an absolute, like, Pokemon genocide. Hoot hoot. Well, that's a Noct Owl.
Bulbasaur! Mokuba, speak to me! Bulbasaur!
Well, we know that she's a mature trainer because she actually uses, like, status effects attacks, and it's just not all 100% offensive attacks. She's also got swagger. That was a bit aggressive. Go, Cyndaquil, like 2 inches away from her. Yeah, I don't know if you want to go headbutt against a fighting type, but okay. Flamethrower! Okay, he nearly killed the trainer. Okay, never mind. They are fighting to the faint. Cyndaquil just annihilated a Mankey. Oh, That Quagsire, or yeah. I don't know if electricity is gonna work. Is that a ground type? Even though you think it's a water type? Whoa! Yeah, this is the kind of crap you can't do in the games. I mean, I guess that could be a headbutt move. I don't know if Pikachu can learn headbutt, though. Ah! Totodile didn't even fight. Don't worry, Totodile does get a victory dance in this movie.
Baba!
Hashtag Bulbasaur propaganda. Lisa doesn't hang out much. You're one of the toughest trainers I've seen. Okay, it takes him like 25 years to win a league, so let's slow your roll there. No, they haven't. It's not in the games. It's not in the Johto League. Over the river and through the woods, the green field we go. Oligarchy makes everything beautiful. Oh no! Oh, dramatic zoom in. That doesn't happen in the anime. Hold the phone?
Wobbuffet!
Oh, poor Wobbuffet. Your influence is expanding! Is this really newsworthy? Like, it's the Pokemon world. Stuff like this happens all the time, right? Get it? Oh my God! They knew each other. Meanwhile, one region over. Hey, isn't that Tracy from Cinnabar Island? What do we know about them? Tracy, I just told you, they're unknown. Wait, is Molly's mom missing because she went off to have Ash? is Ash's mom and Spencer, did they get together? Did we ever find out who Ash's dad is? I mean, I know the joke is that it's Professor Oak, but still. How long did they have to wait? He had to come all the way from Kanto. Why? Also, what is Pikachu doing? Bad touch. Where did her mom go? Did she get eaten up by, like, the unknown, and that's why her dad is trying to find them? Sorta. Oh my God! Actually, a pretty cool effect. Yeah, Pikachu would normally get annihilated by Entei in a fight. This is so weird now. This is so weird now. I'll be your mommy now. I'm getting some real Samoa Joe vibes. Entei was like, nah, no biggie. He knows his mom is out there. That was anticlimactic. Okay, well, here we go. You are mama. We know Molly's delusional. Because, no, that's not your mother. Boy, Mom, you sure look different. You changed the hair and everything. Oh no! Like, what is even the point of this? Like, why even expand your ground? Is this the unknown's influence? Because I thought they were just following the desires of a little girl. You think she'd be happy with just, like, a little tiny secluded sector? Oh my God, it's the Emperor of the Crystal Tower, Entei. Even though he's truly fictitious. Boy, it sure looks a lot different from 2D to 3D. Were you? I was afraid that this cockamamie story was real. Oh yeah, here's Ash's Charizard. I can't. I like the Lady Charizard in there with the bow on her head. I need to look up Ash and Charizard's relationship. Because, like, Ash saved his life, and then, like, he was a total ass to him. And, like, he lost the Kanto League Championship because Charizard refused to battle. But, like, so, like, they're, like, tentative friends, I guess? I wonder how that storyline ended. If it did, anyway. Oh no, she stumped her foot! You know what that means. Icebergs! Ah! Ash and Charizard. Ash's Charizard. Well, there was a picture of a relatively recent, yeah, Pokemon Journeys. Did she just use Skype? In 2001? Sometime before Charizard had battled against Ash's Infernape before he had left the lab to battle Moltres. Why the hell would a fire type fight Moltres? It's like they don't understand how Pokemon works. Good. Play some Pokemon games. If you want to beat a Moltres, use a water type. Like Suicune. Despite retaining his fiery nature and fiercely battling spirit, Charizard's return to Ash's regular command in Pokemon the series Black and White. So I'm assuming that woman, okay, that woman we just saw was Liza, okay. She is the caretaker of the Characific Valley. And there's like, I mean, I already knew that there was some deep lore in Pokemon, but like, wow. Especially when you watch the anime and not just the games. In Mystery on a Deserted Island, Ash used Charizard to battle a wild Ninetales. Why would you do that? Why would you not use a water type? Has Ash never played Pokemon Yellow version or Gold version? Oh, that's cool. Blast. Oh, well. We're going into ice again. They have a list on here. Moves improvised. Pretty cool. It's like when they combine moves. It's like they're trying to, like, reconcile with how different the anime is from the video games. I love Jesse James and Meowth. You would think like a lot more people would have shown up right now to report on this, now that it's become violent. Brrrr! Yeah, back in elementary school, I loved improvising Pokemon noises. Why isn't Molly watching them on her Skype computer? He's looking for a way to advance the plot. In Spell of the Unknown, Entei, Charizard saw on Liza's TV news footage of Entei abducting Delia Ketchum. That's all I'm going to say because I don't want to spoil anything, even though this came out 22 years ago. Oh my god, all these people are so dumb. There's something seems weird about this. I can't think of Pokemon the movie 2000. It's been so long. It's probably literally been since it came out that I saw that movie. I can't remember. For whatever reason, like, the first three Pokemon movies, I didn't see past that, so I don't know about the later ones. But, like, part of this, the themes in this film revolve around, like, childhood trauma. The first film revolves around, like, the ethics of cloning. Like, they got into, like, some serious topics. I'm curious what if anything, like the movie 2000 was like, what that involved. That doesn't happen in the games. Also, if Professor Hale had just consulted Professor Oak earlier, this probably wouldn't have happened. That's my Vulpix! Yeah! Why do they have to, like, actually say it? Like, surely the Pokemon can, like, figure it out, right? Here's your Totodile victory dance. Happy Totodile! Okay, now this becomes a lot like Harry Potter. Just watch. Which is strange, because these didn't come out, like, at all. These were both in production at the same time. Well, I don't know, because this was localized in 2001. Maybe Pokemon, the Sorcerer's Stone ripped off Pokemon 3. Yeah, this was released in 2000 in Japan. When was the Sorcerer's Stone? I guess it's possible that Harry Potter ripped off of this movie. I'm not being serious, by the way, when I say that. They look like alphabet soup with eyeballs. Why would you need to place a personal ad? You've got the person that can make you happiest right in front of you. Oh, baller. Okay, so that's not really Entei, and that's not really Molly. Not so fast. Yeah. She's my mother now. Yeah, I wonder who's gonna fight in the next match. Bigger. But they just don't care that they're running off. She's not gonna use Entei to fight. Oh, well, I guess she's gotta ride on him. Entei, you don't wanna go, you don't wanna head up there and like stop these people? Oh, Brock. You still have a Zubat, my man? You're in Johto. You like a Golbat? It's one of your dispel items. Man, she's got super lucky. She just pulled off three moves and not once did it hurt itself in its confusion. Best Pokemon ever. Why not a water type? All these people have no idea how to play Pokemon. Arr. Oh, that hurt to watch. Ah, that's some bull crap. Quick attack always goes first. They're also not playing by the rules, which is saying a lot. Okay, you're climbing and, like, floating stairs. Oh, that is a horrible sight to behold. Okay, this is already the worst movie ever. This is already the worst movie of the year that I've watched, and we're only 5 days in. Oh, hell yeah! Now use a water type. That's some bullcrap. It also nearly killed Brock, too. He had, like, little tiny, like, baby eyes for a second. And he was like, "Arr!" Did he only just now realize that these two are climbing, ascending the tower? Oh no, Brock's dead. You're indoctrinated. All these people always are looking through that book, and it's always the same darn page. It's always that same Entei painting. Yeah, Brock's dead. I would say don't tell her that you're a water type trainer, because that immediately tells her, oh, here, let me use all of my leaf attacks or my grass types. But at the same time, nobody ever pays attention to types in this series, so. Okay, I guess that's a fair compromise, maybe. Well, it's a good thing Misty knows how to swim from her time in the Cerulean City Gym. No, it's like it's an illusion. Again, why don't you ever evolve any of your Pokemon? Come on now. She didn't even give him an attack. I don't know. I didn't see the Celebi one. Also a very meta joke for a Pokemon movie. Man, they only spend so much time with these Pokemon, and freaking Brock and Misty can't figure out how to evolve any of them. Vulpix, okay, you've got a, you need to have a Firestone, but come on. Staryu, there's no excuse. I did pet a Mantine at the New England Aquarium. The very narcissistic delusions this woman, this girl's having. What is your perfect father? Somebody who does everything I ask him to do. No questions asked. When did she break out of her, like, mind spell indoctrination? Oh, dear! Understatement of the year. And now Misty's dead. Ash barely remembered. Na 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 dun. Oh no, Zapdos! What? I don't know what that was affecting of. It's a good thing that picture book didn't have a picture of Reshiram in it or something. Like the absolute, like, god Pokemon. Why not? Why does she have to kidnap a mom? Why can't she just, like... she can't just evaporate a mom into existence like everything else. Totodile makes sense because he just recently got Totodile, so it couldn't have evolved already. Donald Duck, return! Okay, the water might have worked. You don't know, it didn't hit him. Maybe that's why Ash is, like, the Pokemon trainer in this trio, because he actually understands types. You're strong. That was an odd dub. You're strong. Look at W just chilling. Like Majora's Mask music. I can't remember if Team Rocket actually does anything to contribute to the plot, or if they're literally just here. I think that's cheating, but this isn't an officially sanctioned Pokemon battle anyway. Charizard! Well, it's a very good thing we had that establishing shot of Charizard seeing this all on television. Yeah, Charizard showing off. The Team Rocket. It's like Lego Batman. They're like the Joker. They can only exist if these three are existing. They can't defeat them once and for all because then they have no reason to be around. I'm Dan Green. I'm everybody's father. We would all be so lucky. Where's the news coverage about this fight going on? Wow, good job protecting Molly, Entei. She's not even around here. Go back and attack Molly now. Entei can't protect her. That's like Dark Souls. Again, Molly's not up here. Good job protecting her. Getting closer. Nice rebuttal. Point. Counterpoint. Counterpoint. Well, that's like Dragon Ball Z. They had that musical thing where the camera was going downward and they played the... So we could say that the people who composed the music for Pokémon 3 the movie were more experienced and knew more than they were doing than the people who did the Lion King remake. So that's a thing. They understand musical film theory better than Jon Favreau. He was about to pretty much decapitate a Charizard. Yeah, you never have to learn that lesson in the games. Everything is just kill. See ya, Entei. The lack of character development doesn't bother me as much since she is a child and, like, children shift moods. Like the changing of the tides, so I mean, she just decided, oh, you know what? Okay, yeah. I want something else now, all of a sudden. The unknown are back with a vengeance! Could you have gone for like the window? Or that, I guess? That's a very long static shot for, like, such a tense moment. It's like, okay, gonna move on. How does he know that? They're literally called unknown for a reason. Now I'm getting some Persona 5 vibes. Officer Jenny doesn't say a single word in this movie. Okay, remember, Ash, you've got Pokémon. Okay, seriously, if Charizard can't do it, what makes you think Pikachu can? I mean, I know Pikachu's the protagonist, but in logical Pokemon terms, really. Ash, you've got other Pokemon that could help out, you know. Wow! Even more spikes. Even the spikes have spikes now. I'm shocked they stopped at all. Like, you'd think they would have, like, skedaddled immediately. Yeah, sir, can still better. Oh, so they're playing on that. I thought it was... they should have played on it like a loophole. Because the Entei was created to protect her, and now that the unknown are a danger to her, now he's able to defeat them because he's supposed to protect her. So even by the unknown's own logic... Again, Ash, you've got other Pokemon. Even Brock and Misty are there. Get your full hills out and get your Pokemon back out there. What ancient magic has been wrought upon this town that is nothing at all like how these unknown are in the game? This was back when we were in elementary school, and like everybody was kids, and like they didn't know any better, and like they were trying to like impress everybody else, so everything, a lot of stuff was being made up just for whatever. And like there was a rumor at school that like if you collected all of the 26 unknown in the game, like something would happen. And like I spent so many hours trying to catch every single one. I don't think I did, but obviously nothing happens if you get all 26. I don't even know if they count as different Pokédex entries. I think it's all just one. See ya. Yeah, this movie's not nearly as amazing as I thought it was growing up. I guess for what it is, it's fine. It's a little Pokemon movie. I do want to go back though and see the Pokemon the movie 2000, because this one, this is like a 21% on Metacritic or Rotten Tomatoes. Audiences polled by CinemaScore gave the film an average grade of A- on an A+ to F scale. So I mean, I don't know, some people like it somewhere. Hang on, let me see Pokemon 2000. Maybe, can I get to it from here? Yeah. Pokemon the movie 2000 made a buttload of money. I think this one did too, as still. Oh, Rotten Tomatoes. Pokemon the movie 2000 has 19%. At the 2000 Stinkers Bad Movie Awards, Pokemon the Movie 2000 was nominated for Worst Achievement in Animation. However, it lost to Digimon the Movie. Oh no, I wanted to watch that too! Everything is crumbling around me. Okay, well, what was wrong with how did the first one go? Maybe I don't need to watch any more of these. hang on. Pokemon the first movie. Oh my god, that was gangbusters. The first movie was $5 million to make and made back $172 million. Hang on. Marketing, Burger King promotion. Philosophical themes were criticized for being too complex for children. 16%. Oh my god! For the first three movies, Rotten Tomatoes, they get increasingly better. So this is as good as it gets. Oh my god. If you take Metacritic scores with any serious consideration. Roger Ebert called the movie a sound and light show linked to the marketing push for Pokemon in general, and said that the movie had no level at which it enriches a young viewer by encouraging thinking or observation. He basically said it's just like sitting your child in front of a babysitter for an hour and a half. Stinkers Award. Okay, so the Pokemon, the first movie, did win Worst Achievement in Animation. Oh my god. Okay, so maybe I don't need to go back and watch all the previous ones. Wait, Leonardo DiCaprio. Oh, that has to do with the adaptation. Someone wanted Leo DiCaprio to voice Ash. Was Pokemon 3 nominated for anything? No, it was not. According to Wikipedia anymore. I guess the... whatever that contest was. Well, it's not really a contest. The Stinker Awards, I guess that no longer existed, or maybe they just didn't care anymore. No, they were still around. Last awarded in 2006. First awarded in 1978. Wow. Oh, they stopped in 2000 and then did it again 2005 to 2006. So they stopped for some years. Well, yeah, this movie, I honestly, when I was sitting down to watch this, I was like, oh man, this is going to be such a fun nostalgia trip. No, it really wasn't. Yeah, this movie's not all that good, but I mean, for a silly Pokemon movie, yeah, it's fine. It's not my cup of tea at 30 years old. But it was when I was a kid, man. When I was a kid, this was the most baller movie ever. This Pokemon the movie 2000, both pretty damn baller. Oh, look, she got a real Teddy Ursa. Daddy, I want a real Teddy Ursa, Daddy. It's always been my dream to do like more of a realistic take on the Pokemon universe. But we need to get back to like watching movies and like trying to figure out good fan fiction material for them. There needs to be like a Pokemon fanfic where like Pokemon can die of old age and like Molly grows up with this Teddy Ursa and it dies and then she goes all evil again. Where was her mom? She disappeared. When did she come back? Where did she go? Where did you go from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe. Cotton Eye Mom, more like it. Look, she abandoned her Teddy Ursa to go back to her mom as soon as she got the chance. How do you think that makes Teddy Ursa feel? For Pikachu and Pichu. Written by Hideki Sonoda, who had no dialogue to write. Well, now this feels like the ending of... Gainax. This feels like... this sounds and feels like the ending of Ocarina of Time. Da-da-da-da! I bet you $10 that, look, they're going back on their Johto adventures. I guarantee you $10, I'll bet you that in the series for television, they didn't mention this at all. They just went plugging right along. Charizard in the games. Oh, Pokemon the movie 20, I choose you. You could actually get Ash's Charizard, I guess. From 7-Eleven stores. Okay, well, yep, that was Pokemon, the third movie. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys next time when we watch something that's not quite so, so much of a letdown, hopefully. Next time we won't base our decisions based on nostalgia alone. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.